factors that I had to consider as a solicitor in this case was whether or not to seek the death penalty. Certainly, the facts and circumstances of this case, it certainly appears premeditated from the statement that he gave, and the killing of two people in the same act and the death of a child in tender years would certainly merit a capital sentence. I discussed this with the family, Ms. Hawkins. She's met with me on behalf of her and her brother, Mia's father. And ultimately, I spoke with Mr. Gregory, Kevin Gregory, Mia's father today, and they both agreed that they did not want the death penalty sought. I also spoke with Mr. Rogers about this, and I shared with them my thoughts on what that would entail in this case, particularly that it would probably put a trial off a year and a half to 2 years, during which time if Mr. Gregory's mental state deteriorated to the point that he was not competent, then he might not be able to be tried and held responsible at all. In addition, I shared with them my opinion that given the state of the length of appeals that are involved in the capital case, even assuming that we did get a capital sentence in this matter, the appeals would probably put the actual sentence, carrying out of the sentence, off somewhere between 12 and 15 years. If we have an individual who's been on death row nearly 20 years sentenced out of this county, and another one for 16 years, that is typical. So that given Mr. Gregory's age of 68 years, as he stands here now, 67 at the time of the crime, it was highly unlikely that death sentence would, even if we could obtain it, would ever in fact be carried out, that probably the calendar would kill him far quicker than the state of South Carolina could. But that being said, Your Honor, in over 20 years of prosecuting, this is just a ghastly case. The thought of what a child went through is unimaginable. If I had sought the death, there would only be two choices available to the jury: death or life in prison without the possibility of parole. I hope that this court only has that one alternative. I've taken one off the table, but I would ask this court to give, if nobody else, I can't speak for his children. I'm sure they're conflicted, as you could obviously tell. But Mr. Rogers should be able to walk away from here knowing that the maximum amount of justice was secured in this case. And I've asked for a life sentence in this matter. Thank you, Mom.